Dhruv, the bold star. The bold star, known as Dhruv Tara in India, is an important shining star. It serves as a guide to travelers in remote forests and sailors at sea in the dead of night. But how did the star come by this name? Here is an interesting legend about its origin. Long, long ago, there lived a king named Uttanapad. He had two queens, Suniti and Suruchi. Suniti, the elder queen, was a quiet and gentle lady. But Suruchi was selfish, arrogant and cunning. However, because of her beauty and charm, the king was partial to Suruchi. Suniti had a son, Dhruv. Suruchi also had a son, who was named Uttam. Not content with the pomp and power, Suruchi had Suniti and Dhruv banished from the royal palace so that her own son Uttam might succeed to the throne. Suniti lived on the outskirts of the city with a son like a common. The king was so enamored of Suruchi that he did not even care to visit them. Little Dhruv loved his mother very much. However, his heart yearned for his father's love, which was denied to him.
"My father is a king. Then why do my mother and I live away from the palace? Why does my father not come to see me?"
Again and again he questioned his mother. However, she had no answers. One day, Dhruv's longing to see his father grew so intense that despite Suruchi having forbidden it, he went to the palace to meet the king. He was then just 5 years old. As he entered the splendidly decorated hall, he saw Uttanapad. On his lap sat Suruchi's son, Uttam. As he saw the sight, his heart was filled with the desire to sit like Uttam on his father's lap.
"Father, lift me too onto your lap."
"You are not worthy of sitting on the king's lap because you were not born as my son. If you aspire to sit on your father's lap, go, perform tapa and pray to be born as my son in your next life at least."
So saying, she pushed him aside scornfully. Poor Dhruv burst into tears and ran to his mother crying. Suniti was very upset to see her normally cheerful little boy in tears. When she found out the reason for his sorrow, she was greatly distressed. Then she consoled him.
"My child, I am an unfortunate woman, and because you are my son, you also have to suffer."
"Mother, I shall find God. I will live and pray in the forest."
"Son, it is not easy to perform tapa in the forest. There are wild animals and other dangers. If one prays with a pure mind and true devotion, no one can harm him."
And Dhruv respectfully touched his mother's feet and left for the forest. Dhruv started his meditation. Having found a suitable place, sat down and fixed his mind on Lord Vishnu. Without food, uncaring of the harsh weather and the dangers around him, he went on reciting the sacred name of the Lord. Days and months passed. Lord Vishnu was pleased with Dhruv's devotion and determination. He appeared before Dhruv. "Open your eyes, child. All your desires will be fulfilled." Dhruv was filled with joy. Dhruv succeeded his father to the throne and ruled ably and efficiently. Later, as blessed by the Lord, he was transformed into the pole star that shines in the sky, and his wish to attain the highest position was granted. His mother Suniti also turned into a star that shone by his side. Thus the pole star stands in the sky to this day as an eternal reminder to us that true faith and devotion to the Lord never go unrewarded.